So you are finally here, in this place between death and rebirth, where life knows no dawn. Come then. Follow me down into the darkest depths of despair. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful blue star that fell to pestilence and rotted inside and out. The more its people clung to life, the more they suffered. Until they curse not the illness, but their fellow corrupt. Thank you. Those who lived, those who died. And the very last of them wished they had never been born at all. In a faraway place, a brilliant star eradicated disease. Before destroying the selfsame lives it had saved. Its people sought ever greater freedoms no matter the cost. then asked, "What is the point?" There were none left to answer. Father still existed, a star without stripes. Where none remembered life's trials or its joys. What its people had gained from ease, they lost to apathy. So they created the kindest, most gentle people. But you still stand. Your determination defies all reason. The souls within me writhe and recoil in your presence. What must I do? What pain must I visit upon you to make you surrender to despair?
No one is unbreakable. What pains one may weather may bring another to tears. But therein lies our strength. For when we fall, our brothers and sisters are there to raise us up again and again without end.
I see. But no matter how much hope exists, ever will there be more despair. Ever will the living pass the present and the past the future. So shall we sing until life ceases to be.
No.
We cannot comprehend. We cannot know. We cannot know. Don't, please. Don't do this to them. To yourself.
Just one good strike.
We will not suffer alone. All will know our pain.
No, you don't.
In ice, a frozen waste, forever silent.
gifted them escape. And rendered yourself powerless. Bereft of the synergy you claim is your strength. Unless you need to call upon the dead once more. Defiant to the last, but you will be one with us ere long. You will be battered and torn and made to crawl. You will weep and wail and curse your impotence. Curse your life as it fades. As we did, as we died. Such pain and sorrow we felt. Such anguish and rage. We tried. But it was no use. Only when we surrendered did we find release. Only when we embraced death. So join us in despair and embrace yours. My ultimatum. What is happening?
At the end of everything, I find you, my friend. I sought something in you once, as you did in me. When at last I understood what it was, I journeyed to Shalion to seek you out. Struck a bargain with the woman who shares your gift. In exchange for lending the Scions my aid, I was given the means to come hither. Gorging upon what remained of the Mana Crystal, I reclaimed the form of the dragon. And, hungry still for our reunion, I rode the light of the stars to you. I take it this is your prey. But why does it still live? Surely it is no match for you. I assumed you would be above something so banal as despair. Am I mistaken? I care not. What I desire of you isn't succor. It is satisfaction. So come! Let us dispense with this distraction, you and I!
You struggle in vain. You will not silence our song of oblivion. never reach the deliverance you seek.
Ends this day. There is nowhere you can flee that we cannot follow.
Even Star must die. So lonely between the stars. We have seen the end. Same end. Again and again. Even Saad must die. If there is no happiness in life, it may be found. No matter. You only delay the inevitable. This is fate. Your time has come. always does. What is this defiance? No! The hatred, the pain, the loss. We cannot suffer this again.
We will stand against fate.
No matter the cost.
We've been here before. Many a time.
Thus do we know.
To never give up.
We'll shine again!
What we saw... What I saw... This can only end in misery and desolation. No life, no star, nor the universe itself. None should hope for better.
no matter where we flew, there was only darkness and loneliness and pain. We couldn't find the answers Hermes yearned for. The answers he deserved. Greetings, you who are my final encounter. I wish to hear your words, share your feelings, know your thoughts. May we please be friends? Yes. I can see them. The memories of a long, long journey. So many people. The thoughts of them overflowing in your heart. What they live for. What gives their lives meaning. There was never a single answer.
Welcome and well met.
You gather pieces of happiness, precious and fragile, only to lose them. Then start again. On and on it goes, until death takes you into its gentle embrace. That which Hermes sent us to find was there all this time. On Atheris. Like a field of flowers, perhaps. At first a single blossom. It spreads and takes on more colors. Thank you for guiding me here. To find these words at journey's end fills me with joy. And so, before I fall forever silent, there is one thing I must do. No expression of regret will undo what my sisters and I have done, or restore what we have stolen. But if you would allow it, I would sing one last song. A song of the newfound joy that swells in my heart. Of the beauty of light when it shines across a dark and starless sea. Now lost to sorrow. Life will spring forth once more, nourished by gentle rains and caressed by uplifting winds. A song of hope. One day, life will fill the universe again. and Hermes will see this and smile. How, I do not know. But I do know that where there is a will, there is a way. After all, miracles happen every day, do they not? I will create a path back to your ship, where your dear friends await. Hold in your heart your desire to return to them, then follow my lead and walk forth. That hope will surely guide you through.
You mean to return to the world where you are hailed as a hero? Hear me then. Not as a hero, but as simply you. As I learned in Alamigo, you are a formidable foe. Stronger than any I have faced. Against you, I need bring my all to bear. I need burn through the candle of my life. This is the sole pleasure I know, and it is the sole pleasure I have to share. And so I come before you to issue challenge and offer singular bliss. If you wish to walk away, I will not stop you. You value life. You do not burn yours save for reasons you deem worthy. Reasons such as those which brought you here. The salvation of a world and its people. The motives of a hero true. But there is more to you than that. You know this to be true. As surely as you know the thrill of pushing your body and soul to their limits. Of confronting ever mightier foes, dancing ever closer to the precipice, wondering if this will be the one to finally, finally fill the void. Such pleasures you seek for their own sake, and no other reason. Is this not so, adventurer?
Ha! Acceptance! At long last! The conflagration of our clash will scorch even the stars! back! Push yourself to your limit and lead to mine!
Let all creatures
be consumed by our ravenous fervor! I have it! Do not tell me your life's fire is already spent. Yes, yes! Rise once more! It mustn't end yet! Until the last of me is spent! Yeah.
That I should lose again. How disappointing. Never have I understood those around me, understood their obsessions. Besieged by their banality, the world is a mire of tedium and trivialities. But in these fleeting moments, there is a spark, blinding. Too soon. What of you, my mirror? Born into this world, bestowed name, bid to seek out strife and adventure. Was this life a gift or a burden? Did you find fulfillment?
Can you hear him? Safe? must tend to... Open your... Please.
Someone, and...
Please.
You can't leave us! Not like this! If you do, I'll never forgive you! So come on! Open your eyes and get up!
Are you with us? Oh, thank the heavens. For a moment we thought... After what you've done, you're the last person to be asking that. You... How can you keep your promise if you're not here?
Another fine show you've put on, my friend.
A fine show indeed. What were you thinking, fighting alone? Never do that again. My poor heart couldn't bear it.
Put yourself in our place. If you hadn't returned, how do you think we would feel? And if that sounds harsh, it's because we care.
We tended to thy wounds as best we could, but how is the pain? That is gladdening. Grievous as thine injuries were, however, I would counsel repose for a time.
Gladdening! There's nothing gladdening about this! When Meteon appeared in here and told us that you were right behind her, we all got our hopes up. But you never came! And when you finally deign to appear, you're within an ilm of your life! Damn you! Damn you for making us worry!
Oh, those were cries of celebration! Anyway, well, the important thing is that you're all alive and in reasonably good health, and we mean to get you back that way. As for your earlier request, I'm quite certain we're in range to make contact now.
Ah, excellent. Let us announce our return at once. I hope you're ready. While you were unconscious, we set out from Ultima Thule, you see. Can you stand? If so, you may wish to see what's outside. We're home, my friend. We're home.
Truly.
They've done it!
Welcome home.
Rah! Yes!
Dearest mother. Dearest father. This letter will be the very last that I write to you from the Rising Stones. As I commit these words to parchment, I fondly recall my journey as a Scion. From the time I first walked into the Order's former halls, to the time I set forth to forestall the final days. At the farthest reaches of the Sea of Stars, we fought the battle of our lives. Fought against despair itself, a veritable maelstrom of it, fed by the resignation that dwelled in the hearts of beings not so unlike ourselves. Full oft have I harbored the same malaise, have I been brought to my knees, crushed by the weight of sorrow and defeat, convinced that I will never rise again. However, I have also known many moments of unbridled joy and happiness. By this truth do I find hope within, blooming resplendent, like the Elpis flower. And thus do I endure. Do I look forward to creating more memories with my friends and loved ones? For from these fertile seeds, yet more hope shall spring forth. And they will grow to become shining lights that illuminate the dark. Thus believing, I leave the Rising Stones behind, as will my comrades. For, as we have decided, after careful deliberation, we are disbanding the Scions of the Seventh Dawn.
You are, Alphino. Everyone is already gathered in the foyer.
My apologies. I'll be right there. At least, that is what the story will be. Sorry to keep you all waiting.
What could you possibly have left to do now?
Oh, just a letter.
I imagine it will be a while before we can gather like this again.
So it must be, if we're to keep up appearances. From now on, it falls to the Grand Company of Eorzea and its allies to deal with the realm's crises.
Meanwhile, we shall return to our erstwhile ways. Retreating from plain sight, to take our place in the shadows once more.
Indeed. For the foreseeable future, I expect that we must work independently as we seek out problems that want for solving. But a day will come when we face another great challenge, and we will face it together, as we always have.
As much as I look forward to that day, I do hope it doesn't come anytime soon.
Well, formal association or no, if any of you should require my services, you need but ask. I'll be glad to keep my lance arm honed.
I'll hold you to that. So you had better keep your link pearl on hand.
So you really mean to stay, Tataru?
Oh, someone has to keep the Rising Stones in proper order. And even a super secret organization requires a super secret base of operations. To the rest of the world, it will be naught more than a workshop for Eorzea's foremost up-and-coming artisan. If you thought our coffers were full to bursting before, just wait till I can devote myself wholly to the crafts.
Plotting to build a mercantile empire to rival that of Lord Lodorito, are we?
I, for one, look forward to your future successes, Tataru. As do I our next meeting.
And with that, I believe it is past time you all made ready to depart. Leave no preparations undone or words unsaid, all right? Now, off with you.